Yes, hello, welcome back to another video from Small Axe Music Productions. Today I'm just gonna be looking, do a quick clip looking at piano and the muddiness that stems in, from piano sounds. Pretty much most of the time a piano would sound good by itself, you know, but as you add the instruments and so forth, you know, it sometimes the low end tends to be blocking some other instruments, are, you know, messing with something, so you have to maybe do some cuts and in the low end, and, you know, fix it up. So I have this beat here working, and I'm gonna be using to do this reference quick, right, just maybe a few minutes. All right, so let's just have a quick listen and then we'll go right in and have a look. Right. R&B, by the way. So I think that's enough. All right, so let's go right in. Basically on my piano. All right, so let's just go from here and see what we can get. All right, I was playing around already, so let's just go right in. Alright, so let's just use a smaller bell. So let's dial in 15 and let's search for that sound. Alright, before I even do that, let's just go on the high pass filter and sweep, and we'll see that you won't be making any changes on the muddy sound in area. All right. All right. Not until I'm up in the 150 area. I would start to hear a slight difference, right? So, which means that that's not where the muddy frequencies are, all right? It's a piano, yeah, but there's a lot of mud in the piano sometimes. So what you have to do is use one of these bands here, like I was using number 4, right? And boost it. Listen for the mud. You can hear certain more than one frequency has that muddy sound, so you will have to determine which of them you don't want, all right, at the end of the day. I catch a frequency here in my headphones. I'm not sure if that's what I would hear openly, but this is the frequency that I would dip this frequency, definitely. All right, it's very mucky. All right, so it can be up in this range, right? The muddy frequencies can be up in this range, people. So wow, I should pull this one out. You can hear like a muddy flanger sound coming out when you boost it. All right. And this is probably the sound that I don't like. All right, let's broaden the band a bit. And see. All right, as you can hear, it's a lot of mud down on the low mid frequency of the piano, and that can cause a lot of problem later on with the bass or the drums, especially if you're hammering one key that's maybe playing the bass riff. It will cause problems, so it's best to you know, dip it out. You know, sometimes you want to make sacrifice. The piano will sound good on its own, especially when it's not playing with the bass like it's playing on a solo basis, and you want that low end. Whatever, you know, I would advise you to maybe use automate the plugin, right? Dip that band and, you know, write automation and bring it back in when it's playing it by its own, on its own, right? Because when a piano is playing by its own, you know, sometimes even the piano player plays different with a bit more bass clef, all right, instead of maybe causing with two hands. You know, because the bass player occupy that frequency, so you will play with the both hands. All right, so you can write automation, definitely. That's my recommendation, by the way, on the plugin. All right, if you want to add back that frequency in it, but yeah, those frequencies, low frequencies can be up here, so don't think you can just throw a low frequency high pass filter on it to sweep out the low end. No, you will get from the low end rumbling, that's probably ground noise or whatever, right? But it you have to work on the piano up in this range, All right, so after you find that frequency that you take out, you can take it out, right? And if you want to add it back later on when the piano does a solo, you can automate it, right? But yeah, just sweep the frequencies and dip it out. It could be here as well, right? Like I say, it's sometimes a personal preference, or maybe other instruments contradicting what you're doing, all right, or what you're trying to accomplish. So, you know, you have to be picky in what frequency you want to dip, all right? So you would just find a frequency and dip it out, all right? And still you would put the high pass frequency later on, all right? Or if you need some more bass or whatever, you can always make a sharp curve down on the frequency that you like, you know? Yep. Alright, and you can go ahead and search for your the frequency that you really like. Frequency sounds good in the headphone and here on the 2K as well. Alright, you probably will put some ear in it. Piano need that anyway. Alright, so of course I have most of the instruments from here on blasting, right? So this is where I reach, so I would go and turn down these other guys here, especially that hook sound that you're hearing. And do my thing, right? So you could hear the piano more transparent, you know, and everything blend, and you know, yeah. But that's basically how you would go and search for the piano frequency. So just not because it's a piano, you just throw a high pass filter on it, and you know, not paying attention as to where that frequency is coming from, right? So you have to sweep and find that bad guy. Right, and dip it out. Anyway, I hope you guys got something today. Right, gonna get back at it. So you guys take care. One love, bless, respect, love. All right.